In 2008, David called me about redoing a track from Off Never Let Me Down called Time Will Crawl. It was a track that I certainly knew well. I knew the whole album pretty well. And that was one of his favorite songs on the album, or at least songwriting-wise. So he gave me his ideas and he said, let's do this. And that's how it began.
Even in 1987, he wasn't happy with the way it turned out. He felt like he'd written really good songs, but he kind of checked out of the process at the production point or the mix point, and it went in a direction that he ultimately wasn't happy with. He had said, well, we could maybe go back and redo a couple of the songs off of Never Let Me Down, which I thought it was too soon for that. So I was like, nah, we don't want to do that. That would be kind of cheesy to redo songs from the album you just did on the next album, whatever that's going to be.
So cut to 10 years later, redoing the album in this fashion, it felt right. It felt like something he would be wanting to do. Immediately, that was getting rid of most of the electronic elements that were on the original. Mainly the drum machine had to go. And his other idea, which shaped it quite a bit, was having a string quartet. He had a very specific idea. It could have been something that Philip Glass or Steve Reich would have done. That was something that was a big influence for him, especially for Time Will Crawl.
And Mario was very particular about honoring David's wishes, and I think probably everything that David said to him about that record was kind of burnt into his memory.
Reeves had come up a little bit later, and that was something that I felt was what the songs needed. So luckily when I called him, of course he was excited and all in. So I was very lucky to have him.
Everybody played great on it. There's no fault on any of those musicians. And it was of the time, sonically, the mix and everything. But it was a little too much dessert and not enough main course.
It's pretty surprising in a sense that you have this album from 1987 that didn't do much, at least critically speaking or artistically speaking, David wasn't satisfied with it. But underneath that layer was these really fantastic songs. So once I peeled that away and I started hearing the content, I thought all these songs are great, even on the songs that he covers. I mean, of course I'm a bit biased, but I don't have any moments on it where I think, ah, that's weak. I think it's all really strong.